Hey guys, Jen here, the Feel Good Life Coach. And I was thinking about, I just keep hearing so many people complaining about this year. Like, obviously this year did not go how anybody in the entire world probably thought this year was gonna go. And I've just heard people complaining about like how the year's over and it's done, and like, there's still time left in this year, right? There's still months left in this year. And so rather than taking on the attitude of, it's over, it's done, like I'm not even bothering, I'm just waiting till next year to make new goals or to figure out what I wanna do with my life or whatever, like, why not start today, right? Why not start where you're at, wherever you're at, with whatever's been going on for you this year, and just choose to just kill it for the rest of this year, right? Like, just kick some serious ass and whatever it is you're doing, like, just, let's just make that happen, right? Like, let's just decide that that's what's gonna happen. Like, I don't know, everybody else's experience has been different. Obviously, everyone's experience has been different this year, but for me, this has been a phenomenal year in the sense of like, I have been able to completely transform my business into the business that I actually wanted, that I've always wanted. And I don't think that ever would have happened if it wasn't for the quarantine and from like everything just kind of going silent for a while. So I'm really grateful for this year. And I'm also ready to really go big for the last few months that we have for this year. So I'm gonna go through, I just wrote down a list of all the things that I'm gonna start focusing on for the rest of this year. And I wanna share with you guys, cause I really want you to also be able to kick some serious ass and really kill it for the rest of this year, so that this isn't the year that threw your life off track or your business off track, right? So that isn't the year that you just, you know, there's still half a year to go, right? So that's really what we need to worry about. Emanuela, yes. There's still half a year. Exactly. That's what I'm saying. So let's talk about this. Okay. So here are the things that I'm going to share with you that are going to help you to actually finish this year strong, like kick some serious ass for the next few months and really have this be a year that you look back on with gratitude and with like, yes, this was actually such a good year. That's how I'm looking at it already. So like, this has been a great year for me and I know it's just going to get better from here. And I'm making sure that it's gonna get better from here by doing the stuff that I'm gonna talk about here. Okay, so the first thing to kill it for this year, for the rest of this year, is to bet on yourself. So we don't back ourselves enough in life, in business, and it's time that we stop doing that shit, right? It's time that we stop acting like we can't do the things we wanna do, acting like we don't have what it takes. Like, we know we have what it takes. We know that we can do the things that we wanna do. And we just need to now bet on ourselves, right? We need to really get behind what it is we're doing or what it is you want to do. Just fully back yourself on it, whatever it is, and place your bet on yourself, right? Not betting against yourself, not betting that you're not going to get the thing you want or not receive the outcome that you desire, but you're really backing yourself that you know you get to have what you want and you get to have it, and that's it, right? Like, there is no any other question in your mind, right? You're gonna bet on yourself, you're gonna back yourself. Like, that is the decision you're gonna make for the rest of this year. That was a big one for me, especially making the decision to change my business. So in March, I'd kind of been in the process of this for a couple of years anyway, but I was still one foot in the old business, one foot in the new business, and I wasn't completely like all in on the new business. And so in March, when a lot of what I was doing in my old business started to go away, not all of it, thankfully, but of course a lot of it did. And it was like, this is the perfect time, right? This is the downtime I've always needed to transition. So I did bet on myself. I did bet that I could make this happen. I could make this transition and that I could finish this year celebrating the fact that I'm now doing what I actually want to be doing in business and feeling so freaking amazing about it. So bet on yourself. That is a big one. Okay. Next is be what you want to receive from others. So everything is a reflection, right? Like, everything you experience in your external world is a reflection of what goes on internally for you. So knowing this, if you actually think about what it is you want from other people, right? So you want other people to be nicer. You want them to be, I don't know, like more friendly, more kind, more giving, more loving, more whatever. Then how can you be that first? How can you create that first inside yourself? And actually by doing that, what happens is that you start to reflect that out in your external reality. So suddenly you're seeing different sides of people who you normally would never experience this from. Like, huh, this person's being extra nice all of a sudden. Like, what's up with that? That's kind of cool, right? Well, that's all about being, because you're being who it is you want to receive from others. You're being what you want to receive from others. So whatever it is you want someone else to give you, how can you give that to yourself first? And how can you give that to yourself now so that you don't have to rely on somebody else to give you the things you want? You can create them for yourself. And by doing that, you're going to experience more of it in the rest of your life as well. So be what you want to receive from others. Okay, next is discipline and good habits, right? So this is a basics, like foundation thing, but when it comes to being successful, doing the things you want to do, actually making progress every year or every month or every day, is that you are disciplined to do the things you need to do. Now, this is not need to do as in everyone else's needs to do or everyone else's to-do list. It's literally what you need to do for your life, for yourself, for your business, if you have one. So it's discipline around doing those things, and it's good habits around doing those things. Because when you have a habit to do something, then it just becomes automatic, right? You don't have to think about it. You don't have to like plan a time to do it or set time aside. Like, you just trust it's gonna happen because you have a habit around it. It's like brushing your teeth. You know you're gonna brush your teeth at some point when you wake up in the morning or at some point before you go to bed. Like, that's a habit that you have, hopefully. And that's something you're gonna do, right? So if you create a habit around doing the things you wanna do, like if you wanna be writing a book, or if you wanna be doing more live streams in your business, or if you wanna be doing more sales activity or whatever, how can you build a habit around doing that thing? And when you start to do that, it just becomes like a natural extension of your day. And it's just a consistent thing that you start implementing. So having discipline and having good habits, especially around doing the things that you know you wanna be doing or that you know are going to be, you know, important for you to do, is huge. And it's also one of the easiest ways to get consistent with something. It's just make it a habit, right? If you just make it a habit, then you don't have to think about it. It's just gonna happen automatically. So good habits, good discipline around things that you need to do, like that's gonna help you to really kill it for the rest of this year. Okay, next thing is self-integrity. So self-integrity for me is just like doing what I say I'm gonna do, right? So if I say I'm gonna do something, it's actually doing it and not just saying it over and over and over again to the point where people are like, oh yeah, there she goes again saying that thing she's gonna do, right? Like, don't be that person. Don't be the person who, you know, people think that about, right? Or people say that about, or that you say that about, right, to yourself. Like, be the person who does what you say you're gonna do. So if you tell yourself, this is what I'm gonna do this month or this week or this year, do it, right? Show up for yourself. Be in integrity with your word to yourself. And if you do this, you're gonna create a lot more trust, a lot more confidence in yourself. And that's just gonna be, you know, helpful to any other thing you're gonna do in your life or in your business. So how can you create more self-integrity for the rest of this year and do the things you said you're gonna do? Be a person of your word, right? Next thing is work on your inner game. So it doesn't matter what you're doing externally, physically, like actions, changes, things you do. If your internal world does not match the thing you desire to have, you're not gonna have it. It's just not gonna happen. So you gotta get your inner game on point. And that's not just your, you know, it's your mindset mostly. It's your energy, it's your mindset, your feelings, your beliefs, your actions. Like, all of that stuff has to align with the desire you have, with the outcome you want, with the results that you want, right? Because if it doesn't, it's gonna be kind of hard to get those things, right? So you need to really think about this and spend time every day working on your inner game, getting your inner game on point, because that is the most important part of success. It's mostly a mindset. It's mostly an inner game. And then the rest is just the actions you take when you're getting to that place internally where you're like, I can do this. I believe in myself. I know I can make this happen. And then you go take action from that energy and from that place. But it's an inner game, right? If you're doing it, same thing, right? If you're taking action from a place of like, I'm afraid, I'm doubting, I'm worrying, I'm feeling like desperate energy, that's gonna also show too, right? And that's not gonna get you the result you want. So work on your inner game, master that inner game. And most of that is your mindset, right? So it's your thoughts, your beliefs, your feelings, most importantly, that what are you feeling most of the time? That is gonna be a huge part of you mastering that inner game and getting your inner game on point. So I always recommend a daily mindset practice I do on every single day in some way, shape, or form. I have a recommended practice that I tell people about. It's one that I've been doing pretty much since August 2015. I've done different versions of it, but this is where I'm kind of at with it now. It's got three parts to it. The first part is clear. So you're clearing out the clutter, clearing out the mind noise. So like freestyle journaling or doing like EFT or meditation, just getting that noise out of your head. The second part is resetting to truth. So this is when you're gonna set intentions for what you're now deciding and declaring and claiming as true for you, as true about life, as true about your business, as true about yourself, whatever, right? So this is resetting to truth, intention setting mostly, setting intentions, claiming what you want to have be true. And then the third part is feel it. So now you're gonna actually feel all those intentions, right? Feel like it's already true. And you can do that by visualizing, you can do it by meditating, dancing, just doing something that feels good to you. But every single day, if you do those three parts in a mindset practice, and it doesn't have to take long, 3 minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, whatever you got, I promise you, everything gets better when you start working on your mindset, because your mindset, your inner game, is really what's handling most of what you're experiencing in your life. So get your inner game on point, get your mindset on point, and the rest of this year, you're gonna seriously kick ass. Okay, next thing is act as if. So act as if is one of my all-time, like, absolute favorite manifestation techniques, tools, processes, whatever you wanna call it, act as if. Now, I always like to say that act as if means acting in faith of receiving, right? So you're acting as if you believe that whatever you've asked for, whatever it is you want, is already done, is already gonna happen. And so you're now acting in faith of receiving that thing by taking action from the place of it's already done, it's already mine. So acting as if is my, like, little secret tool that I use for any manifestation that I want. Like, I just think about it from the perspective of, if I already had that thing, if this was already true for me, what would I be doing? What would my life be like? What actions would I be taking? How would I be being? Like, what would my identity be? Like, how would I show up every day? It's looking at all these little pieces. Like, what would my habits be? My thoughts, my beliefs. And then aligning all that stuff to your goal, to your desire, to the thing that you want to receive. And by doing that, you basically bring it into your reality because you acted your way there, right? You acted as if it was true, and then you did the things you would do if it was already true. So acting as if is a really great way to speed up your manifestations, to get things that you want faster, and to have fun in the process, right? Because it's fun to get to do different things that you aren't doing right now. And for me, like, that's the secret tool, right? It's just act as if. If I want something and I don't know how to get it, I always just think about act as if. So if I already had this thing, if I already knew this was mine, what would I be doing? How would I be showing up? What would I be experiencing? What would my life be like? Most importantly, what feelings would I be feeling on a regular basis? And then how can I implement that stuff in my life right now? And that is gonna be a huge way for you to start really kicking some ass for this year and every year beyond that, is just looking at the outcome that you want and working backwards to figure out, if that was already true, if you were already there, what would you be doing? How would you be showing up, etc.? Because that actually gets you there faster than thinking you have to chase it, right? Or you have to get there. You're already there. If you're already there, what's your life now look like? What are you now doing every day? What is your experience in everything? And then you just act from that place and you take action, decide, choose from that place. And as much as you possibly can, obviously. Like, you do it a little at a time or you do a lot at a time, whatever feels good to you. But the most important thing is that you're really thinking about the outcome and working backwards from there rather than trying to figure out the how to get to the outcome. So that's one way that you're gonna seriously kill it this year. And there's, you know, 4 months, 5 months left this year. And maybe six months. I'm terrible at math, so I'm wrong. 6 months. So you literally have, like, almost this whole year. No, I think I'm wrong again. It is 5 months. Either way, whatever. You know what I'm saying. There's plenty of time to do something this year. There's plenty of time to make something happen. But the fastest way to do that is to work backwards from the outcome and to start there and then to figure out where you would be, what would you be doing, rather than trying to figure out the how to get there, right? Because if you do that, you're just always going to be trying to get there versus I'm already there and I'm acting from that energy. Okay, next thing to kill it this year is to drop the old stories and tell it how you want it to be. So a lot of times we don't realize we even do this, but we'll just keep repeating the same stories about ourselves, right? Like, I suck at that. I can't do this. I'm not smart in that way. Or, like, I always say, I suck at math, right? Like, you just heard me say that. I suck at math. I probably really don't suck at math. It's just I've always said that to myself, so I believe it, right? I believe that I suck at math, so therefore numbers always get jumbled in my head and stuff never gets, like, proper. But if I started to say that I was great at math, you know, that might change. So tell the story you want, not the story as it currently is. So drop the old stories, drop the BS stuff, like, it's not serving you. And if it's already existing, it's old news. It's old news, right? It's already existing. So it's time to create something new. So what is a new story you can tell yourself about whatever area you want to see improve, whatever that is for you, whether it's, you know, your life, relationships, like your business, whatever. What is the story you're currently telling yourself, and what is the new story you can tell instead? And of course, as you start to tell the new story, you start to live into the new story and you start to see different results because of that. So drop the old stories and tell it how you want it to be. Okay, next thing is to focus on doing what matters, AKA the needle moving activities. Now, this doesn't always have to apply to business. It can apply to life. It can apply to relationships. It can apply to anything, really. So it's really just thinking about what it is that you want and then what are those needle moving activities that are actually going to help you see progress every day. So like, for example, for me, in my business, the daily activities are that I do messaging in some form. So whether that's written or doing a video or a live stream, I do sales activities. So I'm always promoting whatever it is that I have for sale at the moment. And I'm always doing some kind of writing because that's a needle moving activity for me, etc. So again, this doesn't have to be for your business. It could be for whatever area, but just look at what are the things that I know are most important that I need to be doing every day and actually start to do them, right? So you're gonna focus on that. You're gonna actually think about that every day of like, okay, what are those 2 to 3, 5, maybe that's kind of a lot, but you know what I'm saying? Like pick a few activities where you're like, if I did this consistently every day for the rest of this year, like I would have killed it this year. Like I would have been in a completely different place in December. Like I'm gonna be super excited. And like for me, one of those things is live streams. So I've been wanting to do more of them. I actually did a whole bunch over the past few weeks. I've done like 15 or 20 of them. And I know I just want to keep this going and I want to try to do one every day, most days of the week if I can. So that's kind of what I know would be one thing I could focus on that will be a needle moving activity, right? Because it gets my message out there. It gets my products and my offers out there. It gets me out there as the Feel Good Life Coach, like all of that stuff. So what are the needle moving activities that you can be focusing on for the rest of this year that will actually help you to achieve the things you want in the next 5 months? Okay. Next thing for killing it this year is, or for the rest of this year rather, is to think in inevitability. So what I mean by that is to think about what would make something inevitable, right? What would make the outcome you desire inevitable? So an example would be like a habit. So if let's say your goal for this year is to have your dream body, right? Like that's what you've wanted for such a long time and now you're finally gonna claim it for yourself and you're gonna actually make it happen. Okay, great. So what would make your dream body at the end of December, like looking back and you know, looking out at December and going, yes, like I have my dream body right now. What habits, what thoughts, what beliefs, what actions would align with that result being inevitable, right? So think in inevitability. So for me, like if I'm thinking about that for myself, it'd be like, okay, well, what habits would be inevitable that by December I would have my dream body? Working out consistently, right? That's a big one. If I had that habit, I wouldn't have to worry about not having my dream body because I would have it, right? So it's like things like that. Think in inevitability. What habits, what beliefs, what actions are gonna make that result inevitable for you? Think about that and then start to implement things that will align with the inevitable result that you desire. Okay, just a couple more things. So the last two things I wanna say is come up with one realistic and one crazy goal for the next 5 months, right? So the rest of this year. I know like you probably had plans in January. I had plans in January. Things did not quite go how we thought they would this year, but that's okay. We get to decide our experience in life no matter what's going on around us. So how can you choose to kill it for the rest of this year and not let whatever's going on around us stop you? Well, another way is to have a specific goal, right? So a realistic goal. One that you think realistically you could achieve in the next 5 months, given everything that's going on and all of that. And then one crazy goal, right? Like one goal that's just pushes you out of your comfort zone, like really makes you think bigger, makes you act bigger. Like what is something that you could do as on a crazy goal, right? Now, crazy is gonna be different for each person. So like for me, crazy goal would be like, if I were to make 5 times what I've made in the first 6 months of this year. Like if I could go to December of this year and I've 5 times my income that I've already made this year, that would be amazing, right? That would be crazy goal. Another crazy goal, making $500,000 in the next 5 months, like crazy goals, right? Now, again, they're gonna be different for everybody. And this is just for fun. You're just gonna pick something because like, why not, right? Why not attempt a crazy goal? Why not attempt something that's outside your comfort zone, right? That really pushes you to think bigger, to do more. So Pick one realistic goal, one that you know you could realistically hit in the next 5 months, and then pick one that's a little crazy, a little out of your comfort zone, but really is gonna give you that motivation to show up fully every day and do what you need to do. So that's another way to kill it for the rest of this year. And the final thing, I will leave you with here, and if you take zero away from what I've said here, take this away. Feel good, right? If you do nothing else for the rest of this year, feel good. Focus on feeling good. Find ways to feel good in your daily life, in every area of your life, in every area of your business. Like, the more you can feel good, the more you are matching the vibrational frequency of whatever it is you desire to have, right? Because everything you desire is because you think having it is going to make you feel better, or it's going to make you feel a certain way, and that certain way is good, right? Whatever word you use for good, it's a good, positive feeling emotion. So knowing that, the only path to get there is also to feel good, because this is an energetic universe, right? So everything is a vibration and everything has a frequency. So if you match the frequency of what you want, you're gonna see more of it in your life. If you don't match it, you're gonna not see it, you're gonna repel it. So how can you match the frequency of what you want? And that is simply to feel good. So it's to think about, how can I feel good every single day? Set a check-in time in your phone, like one or two times a day, where you get a message that says, hey, how are you feeling right now? And just check in with yourself. How am I feeling? Like, interesting. I'm actually not feeling that great right now. Maybe I could do something to change that. Like, if we don't get conscious of how we're feeling, then our emotions are just running the show behind the scenes and basically just creating things for us subconsciously. If you take control of how you feel and you intentionally choose to feel good every day, then you become in control, right? You take the power back. And now you are putting yourself in the energy of all the things you want, because now you're matching their frequency. Feeling good is the point, and feeling good is the path, right? It's the way to do it. So that is how you're going to totally kill it in 2020 for the remainder of this year, right? So maybe the first half of the year didn't go how you wanted it to or how you thought it would. That's just so what, right? That doesn't matter anymore, because that shit is over. It is time to move forward from here. And how are you going to do that? By doing the stuff that I talked about in this live stream. So I'm just gonna run through all of them quickly again, just so that, you know, if you want just like a quick overview and, you know, just to kind of write them down or something. But here are the list of things to do for the rest of this year to totally kill it and end, you know, end the year feeling really freaking good about yourself, really freaking good about what you created this year, and, you know, just that you didn't have a year where you're gonna look back and be like, it was a waste, right? Because that's how I think most people feel right now, is like, 2020 was such a waste. 2020 was a disaster. Like, it's not anything that I thought it would be. Guess what? That's just so what. Now you get to decide that you're going to have a different experience for the rest of the year. And here's how you're going to do it. So again, bet on yourself. Be what you want to receive from other people. Have good discipline and habits around doing the things that matter. Self-integrity. Keep your word to yourself. Do what you say you're going to do. Work on your inner game and most especially your mindset. That's what matters most, right? Act as if the things you want are already done. Drop the old stories and tell it how you want it to be. Focus on doing what matters, what moves the needle in your life and in your business. Think in inevitability, right? So what would make this result inevitable? One realistic goal, one crazy goal, and then just feel freaking good. And that's it. And if you do all those things, you are gonna be so freaking proud of yourself and so happy at the end of this year, and so ready to go into the next year, super motivated, super excited, and just super open to receiving unlimited possibilities and, you know, all the other amazing things that are available to you. So that is all I wanted to say with you, share with you guys today. I hope that you take something away from this and use it. If you do, I would love to hear from you and how it goes. So comment below. If you have any questions about anything that I talked about, feel free to drop it in the comments, because I will come back and check them later. And if you want to create a feel-good business, if you're like, I'm ready to feel good in my business, I'm ready to do things I actually enjoy doing that actually feel good to me, like I'm done with doing things that suck, doing things I don't want to do, like feeling kind of just ugh in my business, like if you're ready to not have that experience anymore and you're ready to really feel good, then PM me right now and I will send you all the info about my Feel Good Business Audit, which is a 2-hour deep dive session with me where we get really deep into every little nook and cranny of your business and look at everything that you're doing, not doing, what feels good, what doesn't, what your ideal would look like, and really figure out a map of how you can start to move forward and create that feel-good business that you actually desire, the one you actually went into business for in the beginning, right, in the first place. So if that sounds like something you could use, then PM me and I will send you all the details about that. You also get 14 days of follow-up Voxer support, so it's not just the two-hour session, but you also get the follow-up support. So while you're implementing this, you have me in your back pocket for questions, for inspiration, guidance, feedback, whatever you need while you're implementing. So I've got your back. I'm ready to help you make your business feel freaking amazing. And if you're ready for that too, then send me a PM and I will send you all the details about the Feel Good Business Audit. So that's it for me, guys. I will see you soon. And until then, remember, feeling good is the point and the path.